Thank you. Well, if you think you have a tough life, then you have not yet met RJ Berger. The Hard Times of RJ Berger is a hilarious new MTV comedy series that will have you laughing. That's thanks mostly to the title character played by Paul Iacono. We're happy to have him here with us today. I like you because you Twitter. So that was good. You got my vote.
You got me.
All right, let's talk first about this. The premise of the series, I was watching some of the clips. It really is hilarious.
Thank you. It's really funny. It's, you know, it's sort of your typical, you know, coming-of-age tale, except that it's emphasizing the awkward triumphs and failures of our youth. RJ is, you know, your average sort of loser kid in high school who is then exposed for being extremely well-endowed.
Oh, my.
And, you know, as you know, some of the men here know, you know, having a big penis is not always a bed of roses. There are... It's true. There's ups and there's downs, and RJ sort of learns
both of them, I guess.
Both of them.
So he's the geek that's gone good, I guess, in some ways, because all of a sudden the women are loving all over him, right?
They're definitely interested.
They seem to be. They seem to want to know what's going on.
There's definitely there's interest, you know. And we'll see if he can sort of master it.
I can't wait to see, because he is adorable with his little glasses. I like what he's got going on.
Yeah.
All right, it's premiering right after the VMAs. That's a big deal. That's a big audience.
Huge.
What'd you think of that?
Amazing.
You'll take it.
I'll take it.
All right. The character we know a little bit about, but what was your initial read when you read the script? Were you thinking like, can I play this role and have a straight face every once in a while?
I was like, is MTV actually doing this? Because it's so well written, and it's, you know, and it's not reality, which is amazing for them to be moving away from that.
Back into scripted.
It's progressive. It's innovative. And it's sort of like, you know, it's the wonder years of our time.
Mm-hmm.
And I think
it's got that feeling. It really does.
It's, you know, it's that coming of age sort of thing.
Yep, absolutely. All right, so you kind of got your start. You started out impersonating Frank Sinatra. I think 4 years old. Is that what I read?
Yeah, well, I mean.
How did that start?
I'm from Secaucus, New Jersey.
Okay.
And
Is that the reason?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you don't really have much of a choice. You sort of have to listen to Frank Sinatra when you're from Secaucus. And, I guess I've always sort of had a knack for just sort of picking up things and imitating
them.
Can
you give us something? Just something.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars.
I love it.
And thank you.
Wow, good. We didn't even let you have your first cup of coffee yet.
I know.
I think that's pretty impressive. So that's how you got started at 4 years old, and, mm-hmm. and it went on from there, because I know you did the whole talk show circuit.
Sure.
People couldn't get enough of you.
Yeah, you know, I was the cute little kid who impersonated Sinatra and that sort of thing, and got me into community theater. And, you know, I mean, I've very much had a, you know, slow and steady process up until now.
It's, really exciting process. You have an interesting story. You went to Fame's High School, and you ended up being part of the remake of the movie.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
Total coincidence. I just went into the audition, and the role was for sort of like a quirky, ambitious filmmaker type. And I was like, yeah, I got that.
I'll take that role.
So, you know, I went in, and I, you know, I guess I had a lot of confidence, you know, having gone to the school. And, and it wound up just being a great fit. And, I mean, filming that was absolutely amazing. We actually went back to the Performing Arts High School.
Oh, that's
and
cool.
And we got to shoot there. And it's just, you know.
That's exciting to be part of all that.
Yeah, you know.
All right. We have to talk. We want to touch on this briefly.
Sure.
You have an inspiring story as well as so much ambition. You were diagnosed with leukemia 10 years ago. Tell us where you are now.
I was actually a little bit more. It was like maybe 12 and a half, because I've been 10 years in remission.
Oh, 10 years
this
in
past
remission.
Summer.
Okay.
So
good for you.
Amazing. And, you know, I do a lot of work with the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society of America, and, the survival rate has gone up something like 35% in the last 20 years.
Wow.
And it's mostly due to their organization, and, I'm very, very happy to be a part of that, and I'm living proof that, you know, you can conquer adversity and go for your dreams, and you can really do it.
Yeah, you sure are living proof of that. All right, God bless you. Good luck to you with everything you have going on. What's next for you?
I'm going to tweet you and find out when we're getting a drink.
I love this. I love this. All right, thank you so much for being here today. All right. The Hard Times of RJ Berger premieres Sunday, June 6th, as we said, right after the VMAs. Be sure and check it out. Suki John will